have provided for you the latest results from our testing, and they are on Knights Ferry, Manton, Highway 31, 84. Those last two are Philco Creek at Highway 76 and Great Park, South Creek. So, we, from those numbers, you see those with the exception of the one on the far right, those numbers are below the 245 to 50 range. It's a recent something that comes into that range. Post signs until our testing.
So have we posted signs in those that have?
Yes. And actually have taken some signs that's just recently down with all of the numbers that's being reflected.
If you see those that test results January 23rd after that.
Yeah.
Are we footing the bill on all this testing? Is the city paying anything on this?
They do their own testing, but we have gone and tested those areas because of those ramp openings you talked about. Individuals have access to some weed. Took it on ourselves to assume the responsibility of making the public aware that those test results were indicative of a potential problem.
It just seems to me that since they polluted our river, they ought to foot the bill for these test results.
Oopsie.
Well, they're all pushing them from them. They may be something further up north.
No, that's not the case.
It is.
And I know, you know, even the dead animal can fall in the river or raises stuff like that.
All we're doing is not assuming that we know where it came from. We're always telling the public the results. Don't know where it came from, don't know who did it, or not.
But these are results.
If it was anybody, we're just saying, be careful.
The purpose of that is just exactly that, to let the citizens in the unincorporated area that uses these public boat ramps, public accessibility points, that either the water is safe to get into or it's not safe. And so that's the reason we did the posting. The city posted only, from a boat ramp standpoint, only on the Highway 133. They're trip drivers. That's the only, that's the city. Right. So they posted that. Some of the posting has come down, or some of the numbers have dropped down in the last 2 weeks of testing.
Yep.
Joe, am I correct to say that the testing cost is somewhere $25, $35, something like that? So it's I hate to say aggravated. It's an inconvenience, is a better word. It's an inconvenience for the county to go and have to test, but we still do have a responsibility to make sure that the water is safe for the citizens to go in at that point if we're going to have open accessibility.
I was just wanting to know also, me, you, and Scott, we went to that public meeting in the sewer spill and how intense that meeting was. I realized some may be true, some may not be true, but long story short, have we received any reports or accusations of us, having any citizens in our south of, say, unincorporated area to Madison to be ill, to have bumps on their legs, or any of that? Because I guess what I'm saying is that Madison is suggesting it. Surely, it's a lot of miles between us and Madison.
To my knowledge, and I'll personally say, as the chairman, I have not been contacted by any citizen in Lowndes County that has had a concern about an illness or something, they may have tracked it out from here. So, but again, that goes back to the importance of the fact that we make sure by this testing that these numbers are clear. And we'll probably continue testing for a couple more weeks until we are assured that these numbers are low. There were some concerns and some issues that was this some trapped materials that for some rainfall and they begin to flush and begin to move out? And yes, was there another issue that was identified? Yes, is the answer to that. I will also say that what you see right here in the numbers, I have been sharing these numbers with Walls, because Walls is testing as well as the state of Florida from Highway 31 South. So just to make sure that the numbers were consistent, what they were seeing, what we were seeing, and so forth and so on. So I've been sharing that information with Walls so that they would have accessibility to that. So far, it seems to be clearing itself up, and hopefully the history of this major spill in the city of Alabasta will be a thing of the past. You're right, Mark, from the standpoint that you can have elevated E. coli numbers just because you've got a dead carcass of an animal or something that may be in the vicinity of where you're testing. But that should be just that area, not consistent.
So what is an acceptable number as we look at these results? I mean,
if I recall that E. coli numbers that they said at that meeting the other night that we were at, from E. coli count is between 500 and 800. If you're anywhere in that area, you're beginning to get that 800 being, if I remember right, 800 being the number that says that it's
still have problems with Philco South equipment, because it's in the 378.4. That's the most concerning thing, I guess, right now. And we're assuming that those numbers will, because I mean, it's actually up from the last testing on the 23rd.
South equipment issues.
Yeah, and those are the issues that we were trying to also identify, is that, as we said, is that it's not necessarily the issue we've had, it's been from one municipality.
This South equipment number 378.4, is that water coming out of Brooks County into the Withlacoochee River?
Well, eventually, the Philco flows into the Withlacoochee. And so what we were doing, because we were getting high numbers at the Knight's Ferry landing, where it comes in is above that. We were getting low numbers at 84. So it was telling us that there might be another source. So we tested this information. We tested the Ocotillo Creek north equipment, and then we tested south equipment. And you see the result.
Do we have any idea of what's causing them to have elevated do they have an idea?
All we're doing is reporting them.
We're just reporting them.
I have a question for
somebody else. I'd like to hold up our process here for a minute and let Paige get going about the
So, just the reason I've been on my phone so